Hello guys, welcome to Survival Russia. We're at the homestead, as you can see. This Sunday video here, we're gonna take a look at a Russian manufactured tent. I've never tried hot tenting in the winter. And this is one of the things that this tent, the UP2, the UP2, Universalnaya Palatka, it means universal tent, can do. It can do a lot of stuff actually. It is a really, really awesome tent. I got the tent and I got the oven there for a very, very reasonable price. But enough about all this blah blah blahing. Let's take a look at the tent. So this video here is basically gonna be first impressions, and I'm gonna pitch the tent, and we're gonna take a look at the oven and all that good stuff. I'm not gonna run over every single detail of this tent because there are really a lot of things to talk about when it comes to this tent. But as you can see, it's not really that small. It's not super lightweight. But for its size, it's actually pretty lightweight. It's I think 22 or 26 kilograms, and it's 1.25 meters wide, so it fits easily in a trunk because of a car. Because this is of course a vehicle tent. It's not exactly a backpacker's tent, but it will fit very nicely into the mini crawler, I can say. One of the reasons I'm really excited about this is, of course, as I said in the intro here, that I've never ever tried the hot tenting before. And yeah, it's gonna be very interesting. But let's take a look at the bag here first. We have like a rubberized upper. We have a rubberized lower. Not that upper and lower, but yeah, upper and lower on this bag here. Just like, you know, big straps, they can be adjusted, so yeah, you can put it on as a backpack if needed to hike from the tent, from the car, whatever, tra-la-la, to carry two people, whatnot. Then we have some compression straps here in the middle, some reinforcements here, more compression straps with Fastex buckles in each end. Heavy duty ziplock, blah blah blah. Let's get into the tent here, because after all, what we are here for. I have not pitched this tent here before. I have not set it up whatsoever. So yeah, let's see how it goes. But it should be super super easy. And I of course looked at some Russian reviews on this tent here. So I'm not completely unaware of what's going on. Inside of the bag here, which is a little bit rubberized here and is really, really heavy duty, we have, let's see, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have a heavy duty bag here, which I will assume contains some tent pegs. And it does. These are quite, looks like heavy duty. Tent pegs, rebar tent pegs, awesome. We have a little bag of spare parts, I can see. We have a nut, a little bit of a screw, Fastex buckle, a big thingy here. It's actually the lock for the tent. And we have some fabric material and some Velcro straps. What do we have? We don't have anything. There's nothing more in the compartment here. All by itself is not that heavy actually. I can see that the spare part is definitely, the spare nut is definitely for this part here. So yeah, a little Fastex strap here. Voila. Let's see how we are gonna do this. What duck was? It basically opens like a giant umbrella, but you have to work for it. Not want to you say, open up the umbrella to its max and fold out the skirt down here. Alright guys, so as you can see, the general construction is up. Let's get into the tent and let's look at the giant umbrella here. Alright, so this is the umbrella construction, and this is the umbrella handle that you really have to pull hard. Unfortunately, we cannot remove this. That is not true. We can remove it, and we should remove it. This is an aluminium rod, and I can say the whole frame, everything is made of airplane grade aluminium. Then we have this little guy here. We're gonna take a look at the frame a little bit later, but this little guy we put up here, this sort of like locks the top of the umbrella here. Awesome. So the tent here is called a universal multifunctional tent, and it certainly is. It has a lot of, built-in features for different kinds of use, for ice fishing, for hunting, and of course just for recreational use, but this is of course the three main uses this tent has. The outer material is made of what is called Oxford 300 PU 4000. I have no idea what it is, but it looks pretty sturdy. It's very heavy duty. As you can see, it's a double wall tent. The inner fabric here, the inner material, it's a little bit different than the outer material. I'm not 100% sure yet what is the inner material made of. One thing that is important though, it is of course to pitch the tent properly. Pitching the tent properly with the cordage will of course open up the tent a little bit more, and it will also separate the two different layers, right? The inner and the outer layer from each other. The reason it has two layers and it's a double layer tent is that it contains the heat better, and it prevents or reduces condensation a lot. Also, the tent here can hold six persons without equipment. That means if you're storing the equipment outside and you can say in an emergency, or if you really have to, you can be six persons in there sleeping. I would say that most likely two or three with equipment is the ideal, but this tent here is huge. I think it's 340 across and it's 1.90 meters high. Let's get in and take a look here. So this section here is of course for the oven. All this is glass fiber, as I have learned. It can be removed and changed if need be. So this guy we of course can remove, and we can put the oven there. And by the way, out in the bag for the tent, there is a piece of glass fiber. It's not asbestos, but it's a big heavy duty piece of glass fiber to put the oven on. We have down here a heavy duty ziplock, so we can unzip the floor and use it without floor if needed. We have these small thingies, these small openings, and they are made specifically for ice fishing. That's pretty neat, I think. We have an upper pocket, then we have two lower pockets with ziplocks. We have a small pocket here. We have the same pockets over there. And we have some storage space up here. This is actually not flimsy at all, this knit material here. And we have a small carabiner sitting everywhere. And it seems like this netting here can be removed. It's only put in place with toggles, so yeah, also pretty neat. We have carabiners for whatever all the way around. This pocket over here is actually for the floor itself, so we can pack the floor up and store the pocket floor in this little pocket here. I think it's a pretty neat tent, I must say. I really look forward to taking this into use. Alright guys, so here we have a window. It's a multi-layer window, I can say. Here is the first part. It can be rolled up and locked with the toggles here, of course. What we have here is a window screen to transparent window screen. This window screen here can be completely removed if you want to. This has Velcro all the way around. Here we have another layer. This is the actual outer layer. What do we have here? Here we have a mosquito net. And finally, we have the inner tent, which is not flimsy. So the window here, of course, has a lot of uses or options for uses. We can take the outer layer and put it in. Just put the mosquito net up and put the window down so we can use it as an observation post or just light. I mean, the observation post for hunting, right? And while we are here, let me show you this, the frame up here. This is the top of the umbrella, as you can see. And it's all metal construction, aluminium and steel. The aluminium, as I said, is some aerospace, airplane-grade aluminium. It has some Russian designation, but it's most likely equivalent to 6065 or 7075 aluminium. I would guess so. Here we have a little rod kind of a thing. That means that it of course can keep the window open if need be, if it's warm. So we have a few items down here. We have this little funky item here, and we have this little item here. This is the pouch which contains the fire safe material for the oven. We're gonna put the oven. This here is a door. It's actually pretty cool. Like that. So now we have a door with a handle. We also have a nut and bolt there. We have this aluminium frame. I said everything is all steel and aluminium. It's pretty nice. Okay, so the door attaches with this Velcro stuff here. And over here we have the corresponding Velcro. So I'll see if I can attach this. This is my very first time with this tent here, so yeah. Okay, so we got the door on. As you can see, up here and on this side, we have some elastic band. So when I'm tired looking at my wife standing there and Phil, I can just go in and close the door. And then I can go out in the back and say hello to wifey again. We have a kind of a tarp so we can have I don't know how dry it will be, but we can of course regulate it. But yeah, it's just like a overhang. The overhang here, it attaches to these toggles so it can just be unbuttoned and it can fit over on the other entry exit. So this is basically what the outer material is made of. Oxford 300 PU 4000. It's not flimsy tent fabric, you can say, and it feels a little bit rubberized on the inside. What do you say?
I would not say that it's rubberized, but it's a very heavy duty nylon of some kind, well bred.
Alright guys, so I think we've been talking enough about the tent here itself for now, or for this video maybe even. But let's try and take a look at the oven. Let's try and install the oven because I'm super excited about the oven and having a tent which holds an oven. It is super, super awesome. So what we have here is where we are mounting the oven. And of course we have this little window here with Velcro. And the inside of this is really thick. There's also glass fiber. So here we have the two stainless steel rings and we have rolled up this little guy here, the little hatch. So let's get in and see if we can get the oven done. That's how it opens. Voila. So this little bag, we have the oven, as I said. Let's see how that goes. This should also be pretty simple. I see we have a smoke alarm. With a battery, that's pretty awesome. Not a bad idea. As you can see, we have all the chimney tubes inside of the oven here. Let's get them out. So we have a little pouch here, which I certainly hope contains the legs, and it does. Here we have a leg, aluminium with a little bit of a rubberized padding. Just put it in and use this wing nut here. Tie it down, pretty easy. So here we have the stainless steel oven. We have a handle here. We have some heat shield on the back. Some heat shields here on the sides. They can be adjusted, but we're not gonna use it. I think it's just for, taking up less space, right, on the transportation. But they can of course be expanded. As you might have noticed, the exit, or what we can call it, from the oven here is in the front and not on the rear. You can see we have a plate down here actually, so this air has to circle in the back and up here and out. I think it's gonna serve a little bit like a spark arrest or something, because there are no spark arrest for the oven or for the chimney here itself. But let's get it on, see how it goes. So that's the chimney. It is way up above the tent, so I doubt that there's gonna be any issue with the embers and sparks and so on rushing down the tent or falling on the tent. I doubt that there'll be an issue with it, because there's been put a lot of thought into this tent here, I can see. So I guess they would have added a little bit of a cap for the chimney if need be, but it would be awesome to have actually for rain and stuff like that. So yeah, maybe they have it as an accessory, who knows. So we of course have the burn chamber here. We have this little lid that of course fits on here. And this little guy here is how we regulate the airflow, just by sliding it in and out or removing it altogether. You can see this is approximately the space that I would take up in the tent here. It can easily be one more and one more. My wife and I were actually sitting out here, and Mr. Survivor Russia was mentioning that from the outside it actually doesn't look that big, and it doesn't, but on the inside here there's a lot of space. There's really, really a lot of space. It's pretty awesome. And what is also pretty awesome is that you can actually make sauna in this tent. It's designed for it. So I guess the temperature rating for this tent here, it will be from 90 degrees Celsius to whatever temperature, minus 40, minus 50, minus 60, whatever. It is a real expedition tent actually, and I've seen many Russians use it in severe winter conditions. And another thing Mrs. Survivor Russia was mentioning, because she's a tailor and a designer actually, that is that this is not cheap materials at all. So it's pretty needless to say that I'm of course totally excited about this tent here, and I really want to thank my fellow YouTuber for giving me a heads up on the company here, contacting him in the US, and the contact going back to Russia. That's pretty, pretty awesome. Check the links in the description, and please consider supporting the channel and share and subscribe, so bell, like, all that good stuff. Until next time, get out of the train, get it done, do something awesome, and let's see how this tent is taken down. Because I said, I never tried this before. Let's see how it goes. I definitely have to put this aluminium rod back into place. And then what? I have no idea. Ah, I like that. Awesome. I'm so happy that I just sit here and hug my new tent. See you guys!